name is Soji Ogunnaike. I work with Rushing Tap. It's a video production and marketing agency based in Lagos. My first big idea started from when I was still a freelance video professional. I was a video editor, a freelance video editor then, and this was about 2004. Yes, so while doing some research online, I realized that most Hollywood studios use this particular software to edit, video editing software called Avid Express Pro. I found out that nobody was really using it locally. And I decided to pick it up. You know, I found the student's version, you know, I installed it and, you know, learned it on my own. You know, people thought I was crazy, but I knew that, okay, at some point, you know, our industry will evolve to that stage where, you know, the really serious productions or the really serious projects will require such expertise. And it paid off eventually, and that's how I landed my first major gigs. I'm a pretty restless person, to the point of almost being dyslexic, and I have thousands of ideas going through my head every day. So I really can't pinpoint which of them I would say is the greatest idea, but I constantly play with different ideas, execute some, throw some out, suspend some, go back to them later. So what keeps me going is the fact that these ideas keep on coming, so I really cannot pinpoint any of them as the greatest. To pinpoint the worst idea, I won't target the worst idea. I'll say the idea that has made me learn the most from was a decision to buy a car to put on Uber. And it was simply because a couple of people, there was a new platform, people were doing it, and then decided, okay, yeah, let's, people are always talking about multiple streams of income. I'm like, what the hell, let's just see what how this turns out to be. And it just taught me a very big lesson, you know, that you need to understand certain terrains deeper than, you know, what it seems on the surface. And the experiment lasted about 5 months, and I disposed of the car quickly. Personally, the craziest idea that I have executed on would be investing in a professional color grading suite, which was back then in 2007. You know, I think it was the first one around then. You know, so I put everything on the line, gathered all the funds available, gathered extra from family and friends, and invested in this equipment. And guess what? You know, Apple bought the company. It was called Silicon Color then. They bought the company, bundled what we invested millions in, and offered it as free with their software. So till date, I still have the hardware, you know, as a reminder that you know, technology can disrupt you very quickly. The greatest risk I've ever taken was, going into partnership with the co-founders of a current company called Rushing Tap. You know, we realized that content is king, and we needed to start creating content. So, you know, three of us came together to form the company, you know, put, you know, on hold every other thing we're doing, because we wanted, the first project was a TV drama series, which we produced. However, we went into it blind, you know, not realizing how best to monetize content. So that was another key learning. And it taught me personally, you know, the hard way, how to remain focused, especially when you go into a business venture, how to remain focused and how to keep your eye on the ball, especially knowing your business model, sticking to it and not changing it for anything. So I learned that, and that's been the craziest step. Founding a company called Rushing Tap, which initially was founded as a content creation company. However, having, you know, learned and having dug deep into business of content and monetizing content, I've realized that, look, if you don't have the necessary capital and resources, you cannot go into that industry. You can't go in small. So the company has evolved and realized that, look, the success of every business is the cash flow. You know, and when you don't have enough resources to produce content and monetize, often having, you know, more than once, your cash flow will be negative. So that's what really pushed us to evolve the company into an agency. It's a video production and marketing agency where we now, you know, get, you know, clients on retainer and who pay us on a monthly basis, which, you know, has greatly improved the cash flow. And, you know, that's what is taking my time, trying to grow that agency. And another thing that we're trying to do is, because I know that eventually, you know, that's going to be disrupted by technology. You know, I mean, look at the way advertising has been disrupted. We have Facebook, Google, and, you know, and the likes have disrupted the way we people buy media online. So I know that that's also going to be disrupted. I know that one day, you know, the cameras, like the cameras that are being manned today, will probably be automated and be operated by robots. You know, because today there are people that are doing heavy research in AI editing. So we're also developing an app, you know, where, you know, videos can be created for brands and individuals, and it'll be automated. The editing will be automated. So that's what we've been working on, and that's really what is my next step. I won't call it failed because the company we're currently run. It started off as something, and it has evolved, leading to, you know, a change in the board composition. So obviously, people have had to leave, people have had to, you know, join. And the major lesson I learned from that was, you know, when you co-found a company, you know, you really need to look at it as a marriage. You know, you cannot go into business with someone without understanding the person deeply. It's like, you know, marrying the first person you date. If you go out to a bar, marrying the first girl you meet, you know, and then that is that risky. So you need to learn, if you're going to go into business with people, you need to know them deeply and intimately, regardless of who they are. So that was a major lesson I learned from that. Another field venture would be the Uber stint. I won't call it a venture, but I also learned that you do not. You know, follow the crowd. That was a major lesson I learned from that. Don't follow the crowd. Many people are doing Uber. Where are they today? Most of them have sold off the cars. That's the truth. A lot of people that bought it, you know, have sold off the cars. And my key learning then was, you know, we were not, as the operators, the people that bought these cars, we didn't identify what the competitive advantage was. You know, why would anybody take a ride in my car as opposed to the next available car? So the platform always wins in that regard. Okay, right now, you know, because of the stage I'm currently at, which is trying to grow and scale an agency, the person I want to meet, you know, is a guy called Jason Swain, because he's a young guy. He's in his 30s, he's based in the US. And what he's done, he's been able to grow, scale and sell, you know, multiple agencies, and that's a very interesting concept to me, especially in Nigeria, where you've never heard of someone acquiring or selling off agencies. It's a new idea. So the guy is really following his blog, his podcast, and his YouTube channel. I've learned that, look, the agency is pretty much a cash cow that you can prove to be a viable business and sell off to investors, making a huge return. You know, you can have as much as a 100, 200x exit as an agency owner. So that has really got me thinking, and I would really like to have intimate conversations with him to learn how to do this. I honestly believe that there is no service without being active. So when you say active service, service is service. And I intend to serve till I die. You know, but obviously in very different capacities. I mean, today I serve, you know, consultancy, render services, professional services. You know, eventually I want to move on to the point where I'm advising business owners and I'm investing in businesses. I'm still going to be rendering services because I will be advising the operators of the business. So eventually plan to have some sort of fund that will be investing in startups. So I don't think I'm ever going to retire from service. I believe that that's why we are on this earth, to keep on serving and, you know, work towards a greater good. I strongly believe that every leader should have what I call self-awareness, because one thing that's been happening is people tend to try and copy other people's methods, and this has led to, you know, a lot of painful failures. And when you know who you are, when you know, you could be an introvert and you're trying to copy someone as an extrovert, it's not going to work, you know. So self-awareness is one of the most important traits of great leaders. Know who you are, know your strengths, know your weaknesses, and capitalize on them. So don't try to be everything that you see outside. You know, just search within. And as I usually always say, operate beneath the hype. You know, there's a lot of hype in every industry. Try and operate beneath it. You know, focus on you, focus on what your core vision is, and focus on why you are where you are. Imagine a world where you can tell very unique and intimate stories using video that is captured and by the guests of your event, not by professional videographers. So that is what our video, AWAVIDEO, is trying to create. It's trying to create that world where, you know, event owners, you know, individuals that are having parties can create project guests, you know, already used to taking videos on their phones, just tie into the app, record and send without even downloading any app. It's all browser based, and all of these videos are automatically edited using AI algorithms, and you have a finished video. That's the event owner or the owner of the party, you know, have a finished video in less than 2 hours. So that's what our video is trying to create, and we're working tirelessly to achieve that goal. In recent times, my favorite book would be The Third Door by a very young guy called Alex Banayan. And it tells the story of this young guy who set out to interview the most influential people in the world, you know, the likes of Oprah, Bill Gates, Warren Buffett, you know. And it tells the story of his struggles while as a student, you know, he was able to get into, you know, these quarters. You know how difficult it could be to get a sit down with Larry King, Bill Gates, and the likes. And I was able to do it, you know. It's become a New York Times bestseller. And I'm not sure if I can remember verbatim the quote, but my favorite quote is pretty much the name of the book, Third Door. It says there are three doors in the journey to success. There's the door, you know, where the privileged people have, where they get to the door and the door is open for them. And there's a second door where you got to work hard, try and break in. Then there's the third door, which, you know, most people don't even see, which is there is no door. It's either you go around back, create a door yourself, go in through the window, go through the several obstacles and get to where you're going. That's the third door. So it just tells the story of tenacity and why you should never, ever give up in the quest for achieving your goal. Okay, right now it's something that we started using as an agency, as a collaboration and work tool. It's called Basecamp. It's both a desktop app and a mobile app. But, you know, it's pretty much like Slack on steroids, because it does project management, it does collaboration, it does internal communications. And it pretty much put your entire office in your hands. You can set assign tasks, you can check what people are doing, you can comment on things, you can do all sorts of things while on your phone without having to scroll through several emails, scroll through different files. You know, everything is within the app, and it's superb. Catch me anytime, and I'm most active on Facebook and Instagram at Soji Oguns, S-O-J-I-O-G-U-N-S, on both Facebook and Instagram. And offline, I don't know how you can meet me offline. Maybe if you offer to buy me a drink, you can catch me in my favorite bars. But that's how you can meet me. Email, I can send you the company email, which is info@rushingtap.com. You know, if you send your email to that with the right subject, you know, the email before that to me. So I hope my very boring life has been, or is going to be, an inspiration to somebody that is watching this show, and hope I'm able to inspire and teach something through my own lessons, my personal lessons, failures, successes. And I'm someone that is very open-minded. I try to share everything that, you know, that has been somewhat a failure, because what I've noticed, and it's something that inspires me greatly, is a lot of the successful, you know, people that we have, especially in Africa, do not share their failures. You know, you hear of their successes and that's all you hear. And I find that very troubling. I find it very worrisome, because, you know, you learn more from failures than successes. You know, but when you hear their stories, you don't. When people document their stories, they don't document a lot of the failures. And I think that's a problem with that narrative, and we need to change it. So, and I would like to encourage the producers of this show to try and encourage more people to share, you know, their failures.